Thus says the Lord God. People shall not be on heart be saying, above and high. I occupy above the throne in the heart of the sea. And yet you are a man and not a man. However, you may think yourselves like a man. Oh yes, you are wiser than Daniel. There is no secret that is beyond you. By your wisdom and your intelligence, you have made riches for yourself. You have put gold and silver into your treasures. By your great wisdom applied to your creating, you have kept up your riches. Your heart is grown empty from your riches. Therefore, thus says the Lord God, because you have taught yourself to have the mind of God, therefore I will bring against you foreigners and most barbarous of nations. They shall go to their swords against your beauteous wisdom. They shall run them through your standing of earth. They shall crush you down to the deep, there to die a bloody corpse in the heart of the sea. Will you then say, I am a God, when you face yourself murderers? No, you are a man, not a God. Handed over to those who will slay you. You shall die the death of an uncircumcised at the hands of your foreigners. For I have spoken, says the Lord God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Looked at them and said, for men, this is impossible, But for God, all things are possible. Then Peter said to him in reply, "We have given up everything and followed you. What will there be for us?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, I say to you, that you who have followed me in the new age, when the Son of Man is seated on his throne of glory, will yourselves sit on 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. And everyone who has given up houses, or brothers, or sisters, or father or mother, or children or lands, for the sake of my name, will receive 100 times more, and will inherit eternal life. But many who are first will be last, and the last will be first." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
But there are also rich people who have hold you still with the attachment of the riches. People like Zacchaeus, who shared with the poor, who turned to Jesus in his riches, he turned to Jesus. And even as a disciple of Jesus, power to the Spirit. It is to these people, both rich and poor, who Jesus addressed the first beatitude. Blessed are the poor in spirit. There was social injustice there at the time of Jesus. He denounced the leaders of Israel for not taking care of the poor and forgetting them. For this reason, these two episodes, one from the prophecy of Ezekiel, the other from the story of Jesus and his apostles, about being detached from the riches, about giving up riches in order to follow Jesus. This story is relevant to our day. It is sometimes difficult to understand how some Filipinos, in the midst of massive poverty, can be some of the richest men in Asia and some of the richest men in the whole world. It is to see the gap between rich and poor. That gap is not due to human industry of the rich and the laziness of poor people. That gap is due to social injustice built in the politics and the economics. That is why the lesson for today, the lesson to be aware that preachers are meant for God, are meant to be subordinated to God, and that we, rich and poor alike, and to fight social injustices and not to promote them through a common practice of poverty and spirit. This lesson from the Gospel is that relevant to our day. We look at our social situation and ask God to heal our broken heart.
Thank you.
is that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, your Almighty God.
Mystery of faith.
we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to fullness of charity, together with Francis, our sacrifice, Romola, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen.
Look not on our sins, but upon our faith of your church, as are those called to the supper of life.
Glory to the Lord, we pray that you should ever remember you. So please see you during this fellowship.
Thank you. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we who are renewed by the sacred mysteries may follow the example of Blessed San Roque, who honored you with tireless devotion, and by surpassing charity was of service to you, to your people, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Yes, for San Roque, the popular saint of the Philippines, there was a time when I felt very close to San Roque. It was a fiesta of a large, small barangay that was also a parish. Yes, for San Roque, when I went to the pulpit, to the lectern, I would give the homily for the call of the parish priest, who came to me and sat down there. And I felt like San Roque. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our mercy is ended, let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
We always follow the ladies here.